ladies and gentlemen. I'm Eustace Farmer, and I hope you're all doing well today. So welcome to a map that's simply named Corn Belt. this is an American map, and as you see, it's massive. The fields are massive. Some of the smallest fields you can't see from one end to the other. This is a fantastic multiplayer map, and for the daring, a great single-player map as well. But you're going to be using a lot of GPS and course play and auto combine and workers and stuff like that, I would think. Because most of these fields, they're a 4 or 5 harvester job, at least. So you start out over here in the center of town. And we're up by field 59, 61, 54, where it says Transport Firma up in the top right-hand corner. So that's where we are here. And let's see. It's got its quirks. As far as errors go, I don't have any. So it seems so far pretty stable. But I have not planted anything or done anything like that. I've only been driving around for a little bit. So, but as far as just being in the environment, usually, you know, you can get a pretty good idea. You know, if you hit certain areas and your frame rate really tanks. So, So one of the things I love about this map the most is its roadway system. This must be like maybe Midwestern, I'm not sure, part of the United States, because it's not totally flat. It's got some hills and terrain and variations and stuff like that. The fields, as you see, some are perfectly square, some are highly irregular. So there's the best of both worlds for everybody. It's got some beautiful waterways and bridges, and it's got some tunnels that go through mountains. So I thought that that was probably the best part of the map. As far as the quirks go, well, one thing I will say is to start off that I don't like that the icons and the text are all jumbled up like that. Makes it very hard to read what's going on here, especially because, voila, there's no description, no backstory, no nothing whatsoever. So this kind of tells me that maybe it was a map that was designed for somebody and their friends to play on, and then they decided to go public with it. I'm not sure. But if you're going to go public with it, put a description on there. Tell people a little bit about it, where it is, you know, what the map offers, stuff like that, for the rest of us. So that is a little irritating for me. But once you get the lay of the land, it's pretty cool. So another thing I, you know, of course, because the sheep is underneath the chickens and the grass and all the other icons there. So it took me a little while to find the sheep. And on this, and you'll see what I mean. On this map, if you're down at one end and you even got to fly with the speed mod to the other end, it's going to take you a little time. So here we are with the sheep. Cute little guys. And another unique little feature of this map. Let me go over to the bus stop in town and I'll show you. Okay. So there we are on the map. Again, we're close to that yellow tipping point where it says Transport Firma. And you'll see the big red brick town hall. And you'll see two bus stops and the little bouncing green triangles. So basically, these are little teleport things here. So one of them is going to take you over to the middle of the map, where you have the BGA and the cattle and all that over by field 44. And then the other one is going to take you to the bottom right-hand corner of the map, down where you see the sign for the woolery, the little ball of yarn. So now once you're down there, those bus stops don't have these icons. So, you know, if that's where you need to be, that'll get you there in one shot if you're up here in town. So otherwise you can just, you know, tab over, you know, to a vehicle that you left down there somewhere. But yeah. But still a cool little feature. So let's go to this one. So let's watch on the map and you'll see. Okay, so like again, I'm up at Transport Firma, top right corner. And boom. Down in the middle of the map now, where the cattle is and the biogas. So, yeah. really, it's pretty cool. You know, it's a lark. It's a, you know, you do it a couple times. You're like, oh, cool. After that, you're like, oh, all right, whatever. So here is grain fill point and grain sales. So another thing is that I'm sorry, and I'm not trying to insult anybody that does not speak English, but if you're going to make an American map, then you need to have the signage in English. I mean, how do I know what's in here? Which one of these, you know, 20 lanes do I pull under to get whatever I need? So, you know, without using Google Translate. Okay. Let's see. Can we go in here? Oh, we can. Now, see, I didn't know that. Wow. So here is... they give you some massive equipment, and they give you plenty of it. So, and then in here you've got some forage harvesters, which is really cool. I mean, look at the storage in this place. Just absolutely brilliant. I love these barns, these hangers. So you got plenty of storage. They, like I said, see, they start you off with a lot of nice big equipment. I do have some American trucks. So I have an International Transtar and a Kenworth. So I'm going to replace the Tatra with those just to kind of keep with the theme of the map. And they do have a little bit more horsepower. And then we've got the New Holland Combines. Now, I guess I could start out with those. I'd like to use some of my mods as well. And I think we'll keep the Case Quad Tracks because, you know, a farm like this, you're going to need it. I don't know about these sprayers, though. They're pretty small. So I'm going to look into an option for that. I do have a John Deere air seeder, so I think this map will be perfect for that. And it's going to be perfect for grain trains. So I have the Wilson grain trailers, and I also have the modded version of these crop tippers, and you can hook them together. And, you know, you could change the color of them and all that, which is cool. And if you've watched my other videos, you've seen them turn up. But you can hook them all together. So we're going to have some nice, big, long grain trains. Because if we're way down, you know, in field 30 in the lower right-hand corner of the map, and we've got to go up to the other side, we're not going to do it one little trailer at a time. That's faux shizzle. And they've got the biggest seeders that the in-game menu offers. So, yeah. Really nice. So while I'm talking about the equipment, let me go ahead and show you in the shop. Okay. So you have two of the T8s. You have one of the Case Magnums. Then you have one of the T9s. Two Quad Tracks. Two New Hollands with headers. The largest. And then the smaller crop trailer. You have three of those. And then two of the large ones, and then some dollies, or a dolly. I think we have two of these. Three, wow, see? So this is really nice, this Lemkin cultivator. So 12 meter working width. And then we have, let's see, three of the horse prontos. And then two of those, sprayers. Two of those. Got yourselves a pickup truck. Then a couple of the augers. Then, of course, you get your standard animals, the dairy cows, sheep, and chickens. Like I said, no fattening animals. Two Tatras and two New Holland foragers with headers, the New Holland brand. And then I have a couple of my own mods in here, my little Chevy pickup truck. I got the Kenworth T8 triaxle. And then here's the International Transtar. And then I also have this version here that's got the trailer built into it in the back, and it hauls just the four standard grains. And then the Wilson grain trailers. So, and here's that crop I was telling you about that you can, you know, color whatever you want. You can hook them together. Really cool. So, and this will all be evolving. Okay. So I think it's time for a little air time. We'll just peek around here a little bit more first. Make sure I didn't miss anything. Let's see. Let me show you the biogas. So over here is Satgut, and Dungur. All right, so here's a little storage. And then you have over here, let's see, this is for fuel. I thought it was propane at first. Yeah, it looks like gasoline, petrol. And then here are your silage bunkers. So we got one, two, I don't think this is one, three, and four, and five. So we got five of those. So you'll be generating slurry like there's no tomorrow here. There's slurry pits dotted throughout the map. Now, these are just decorative, as far as I can tell, because nothing comes up for them. So, yeah, and you can clip through them. So those are just for decorative purposes. And then you can either load into the hoppers the traditional way, if you like doing that, or you can put it through here, which is really awesome. Love that. I did my shoveling days with the wheel loader. I'm over that now. I don't mind just dumping it in there, using a conveyor belt, and then dumping it in. Get her done. Looks like another slurry holding tank over here. Now, this is pretty cool here, too, the cattle paddock. So, like, when you're taking them, you know, bringing them into the ranch and taking them out, you herd them through there. That's pretty cool. Very authentic. Now, what would be sold here? Let's see. Well, that's a tipping point for some sort of something. Here's the manure collection out here, so it's not for manure. So that could be, instead of blowing the straw, maybe you dump it there. I don't know. Because you don't feed the standard cattle the grain on this map, so. And then this looks like it's for your slurry. Yeah. So pretty darn cool. Okay, so over here is where you feed your cattle. And as you see, you got the mix feeders back here. Silage straw and grass, and then program the feeding bot for your schedule. And off he'll go. Or she'll go. Whichever. And then here's some of our static standy cows. And there's one in there. Looks like poor little thing. She broke her leg. Gonna have to call over to the house and have Ma hand me the rifle. And there's the automatic milker. So I guess that settles that. You don't have to haul your milk. And then this is, I guess, an aesthetic thing. He has the static cows out here all over the field. I bought 10, so there's some of mine running around here too. But he has them all over the place out here. I guess so if you don't choose to have cattle, you'll have the look of cattle. And then down over here, another little funny thing. Let's see if I can find it. This doesn't irritate me as much because I can't find it usually. Here we go. So I guess this one was in the process of being abducted by a UFO, and then the UFO for some reason or other took off and kind of left him hanging there. Sorry, old girl. So, yeah. So she's suspended there in the sky for good. So, okay. So, I think it's time to get our fly on. So, I figured we would fly a little bit around the map just so you can get a good sense of the broad scale of it. And then I'll drive a few of the roads. Okay, here we go. Up, up, and away. I won't go too high because, you know, the draw distance is bad enough as it is. But here's one of the bridges I was talking about. Really cool. And you got the expressway down there. So there's no shortage of roads on this map. And I like the double yellow line. It's, you know, seems to be characteristically American. So that's nice. And then the highway signs. Really cool. Nice job. And I've been playing the English map so long that when I first came on here, I was driving on this side of the highway. Not only was I driving on the left side of the highway, but I was driving in the left lane of the left side of the highway. The British maps in Farming Simulator are beautiful. I mean, they're bar none. So I really enjoy playing them a lot. And some of the British maps that I play, like Thornton Farm, and when I was doing Iron Horse Farm, Those maps actually look like a lot of the areas where I live as well. We have a lot of the same features, very lush and green, and the deciduous trees and the hand-stacked stone walls and stuff like that. That's all over the place here in my little town where I live. So I think that's what attracted me the most to them. So, okay, where am I going? You might ask. I figured I would take you for a ride through here, and we'd see, you know, all those fields over in the upper left corner. I'll step on it a little bit for you. But as you can see, so you have that major expressway that kind of runs right down the center. It splits 17 and 11 in half. So, really nice. This is just incredible. But let me show you here what I mean. Let's go to, here's field 15. There it is, field 15. So if you're pulling up in here, I mean, this relatively looks pretty small, but it's massive. I think, you know, well, I'm sure many of you have played maps similar to this in Farming Simulator, but I have not. I usually gravitate towards the smaller maps. So to me, this is just like incredible. I think there's maps like Oklahoma and Graceland and Idaho, and I'm sure that they have some pretty big fields as well. Like I said, I've never been on them, so I don't know. But when I first saw this one, I was just like, good Lord. And then we'll just, I think this is the end over here. Yeah. So I think you get a pretty good sense of that. So there is some more interesting elements that I'd like to show you. And then, of course, we'll make our way down to the where the wool is being sold and the chicken eggs and all that. But we're going to get there in a little bit more of a fun way. So one thing also, and this is something to consider if you have a public multiplayer server. Let's see. Let me hit J. Okay. Make sure it's off. I want to see. I think you can walk right off the edge of the map. Yeah. So, you can run equipment right into the ocean on this map. But yeah, this is really for a multiplayer server where you have trusted members, you know, maybe people that you would invite to come that you know and trust and so forth and so on, because the trolls will have a field day with this. Okay, so let me stop yapping about that and let me go ahead and I want to take you over to an area of the map over by field 53. So I'll be with you in a second. Okay, so I got my trusty Chevy pickup truck, and I just love this little Chevy because my grandfather had one just like this, except he had the full-size bed. It wasn't the C10, but yep, he was one of the biggest potato dealers on the East Coast. So this brings back memories to have the old 66 Chevy. Okay, so as you see, we're up in the right corner of the map by field 53, and I'm going to show you something really cool. So let me go ahead and put the map down. And once we get there, I'll come out of cab a bit too. Put on our blinker. And I don't know if you noticed or not, but there is traffic on the map. Let me go ahead and hide all the HUDs, and we'll really take in the scenery. But this is one feel that you don't get from the air. The air is good to fly around to get an overall sense of the map and the lay of the land, but you really have to be on the ground to experience it. So here's a beautiful bridge. And there's several like this around the map. And look, you got rapids over there. This here reminds me of Colorado. Okay, so here we go, going through the mountain tunnel. Like I said, I have never seen a feature like this on a map yet. And then we got another bridge. Because the river kind of splits in two. And then here we are, and I'll show you where we come out. So there we are. So we just went through that whole mountain from where Field 53 is, and we're down near the top of Field 42, or the bottom of it, whichever how you look at it. But that's really cool. I mean, come on. So, and this is a nice area over here as well. So Field 42, Field 42, 40, and 38. Boy, if you plant all in there, you're going to be here for days. All we're missing is some storm clouds and a couple of tornadoes. But, yeah, I would really like to do some farming on this map. I don't know how much. I'm trying to fit in some things that I've been wanting to do before Farming Simulator 17 comes out. And then, of course, we'll be bouncing back and forth between 17 and 15 until our favorite modders can, you know, get their maps up on the market. So, looking forward to the Mapper's Paradise maps. Just love their maps. Okay. So, since we're coming down this way, we'll just visit the woolery and where you sell the chicken eggs. So it's not terribly confusing as far as getting around goes. You have all your main highways and byways, and then there's secondary roads between each and every field. So there's multiple different ways to get to the same place, but this map is kind of set up like New York City or any big city. It's kind of a grid. So depending on which side of the river you're on, it's really hard to get lost. And the map, I will say, does seem to be accurate as far as your position goes. So that's good. And we're going to test that right now. So let's see, we're coming around the curve. Yep. And our little guy moves with it. So it's very accurate as far as that goes. So if it had a description, and if they took more time to separate the labels and separate them into English words, that would be just icing on the cake. Wow, look at that. This is nice. A nice little area here. Boy, let me tell you something. You drop dead out here in the grass, they won't even find your bones. I mean, this is desolate. So, yeah, got to be careful. Okay, so we're coming down off that little hill area, and I'm figuring we'll see the wool sale point coming up on the left side. Or not. Probably maybe down here. Well, while we're here, let's see where we sell our chicken eggs. Okay, so the chicken eggs, it looks like maybe at the diner. Let's go around the back of the diner. Been having a little bit of a difficult time finding the sale point for that. That could just be me. Okay, there it is. Yeah, so it's behind the diner. So it seems like if you look at the black dot in the center of my blip, it seems that that's off a little bit. Not much, though. I mean, not enough excuse for me to explain why I was, you know, wandering around over here. Okay, so that's where the chicken eggs are. Behind the diner in town. Now let's go and see if we can have a little adventure and find our wool place. So if we go this way. Now I'm thinking it's probably going to be down over there, actually, despite what the blip is saying on the map. Let's do that. Okay, yep. So it's on the other side of the gas station. So you get some grain sale points here and your wool sales. Let's see. Looks like they import fuel down here as well. Oh, what's this going on here? Yeah, unload. Okay, cool. So that's actually grain tipping point, but it's hooked up to petrol silos. So I don't know about that. All right, so here's the rail yard. I have not seen the trains move, so I think that they're decorative. But a pretty cool aesthetic nonetheless. And here's our cattle paddocks, where the cattle come in off the train. Looks like another tipping point over here. Oh, and here you can send off the train. Let's do that. That's probably the standard train though, right? Yeah. Let's do it anyway. Direction pad up. And let's see who goes. Where are you? I didn't see anybody go. There it goes. Cool. All right. Bet it's going to be a long time before they get back. All right, so while we're down here, we'll look under here. This is where the grain trains fill up. So you dump your grain in the trigger point, and then they'll fill up, and off to market they go. Now, I wonder if any of these will take off as well, or if they're just decorative. Maybe if we pull the handle again, another one will take off. Let's see. And no, you got to wait for it to come back. Yeah, so it's just that one. All right, so let's look for our wool sale point here. Probably going to be around the back. I'm going to say right here. That's where the ball of yarn is. We'll have to have some wool to test that out, but pretty certain that's what that is. So that's pretty much it. There is one other thing I want to show you. I'm not going to drive there. I'm just going to pull over and park because it's on the other end of the map. I'll be like, oh, God, Eustace, please don't. Okay. So I'll meet up with you in a flash. Okay, this is not what I wanted to show you, but I thought since I ran into it, you got the waterfall and the rapids here. I mean, look at that. See, there's some really nice, nice elements to this map. It's like a mix of Westbridge, Bjornholm, and Sosnovka. Okay, so here we are. This is a really nice area. It's a road that leads up to the dam. Get up there a little faster for you.
Like, step on it.
Well, actually, this one does not lead to the dam. Let's see if this tunnel... No, it's the tunnel to nowhere. Okay. So you'd have to come in through over there. Through the secondary roads. I'll show you where we are. Yeah. So the road between fields 8 and 3. And I'll jump down for you. Wow, pretty good educated guess there. But you don't have to feel afraid of falling when you have your fly. So this is really nice. Now, I will say, when I played Iron Horse, they had a beautiful dam also. And had a really, really nice, gorgeous view of the valley. But this is very nice, too. A little hydroelectric power. Yeah. So, if you wanted a reference point, I guess, you know, between it fields 8 and 48 and just above 9, that's where you'd find it. So pretty cool. And then you have some nice fields up here. And yes, even we have electrical poles and pylons in our fields. And cell phone towers. That's, you know, something that's really big is, you know, leasing out chunks of your land for windmills, wind turbines, and cell phone towers, stuff like that. That really does help supplement a farmer's income. So I just thought I'd show you some of the textures. So it kind of looks like the standard, well, not really standard corn. Like, not the, you know, giant's corn. It seems like, you know, the common modded texture that you see around. But it's really, still really nice. Really, really nice. I like it. It's got the nice lush grass. But if any of you are looking for, you know, a multiplayer map for, you know, if you have an invite-only server, this would be a really nice option for you. Like I said, I really don't recommend it for a public server because the edge of the maps are not secure. So trolls will drive stuff off the edge of the map. So, and I was driving around with the grain train. Now, I only hooked up a couple of trailers on there. You probably only see, for the most part, tandems anyway, but I'd like to hook up at least one or two more on the back of the truck. I think that's going to come in handy. So, I just thought I'd show you a little bit of what I have there planned. So, and here's our car shop while we're down here. So that's down in the other area up here where you can also sell chicken eggs. There's actually, let me see if I can find it. Yeah, there's another dealership building around in one of these towns along the way where you can purchase all your land from inside the buildings. Okay, here it is. I just wanted to show you before we left because I thought that was important because you're going to be trying to figure out how to buy your fields. And that's the whole purpose of me doing a map tour. So, yeah, I'm down in the lower right-hand corner of the map in town, across from, you know, the train depot there where we sold the wool. And then you just come in this little dealership here, this little real estate office, and all your fields are in here. So that's pretty crafty. I like that. And I know that other maps have done this. Let's do one. My goodness, it's $21 million. Whoa! I'm sure you'll make it. So let's go ahead and purchase this one here, field number 46. And that's $1.3 million. It didn't turn green. And it did here on the map. Okay, cool. So this is showing you the fields that you own, 50 and 49 and 35. That's pretty cool. Okay. I'm sorry for all the walking around, bobbing around here. Okay, so last but not least, so I thought I would show you the sale points. So wheat, barley, canola, corn, potatoes, sugar beet, and... must do wood chips. Yeah, wood chips down at the BGA. Let's see if anything else comes up. I thought, well, it didn't say anything, so I know. It must be the other map I'm about to do. I wanted to see about the soy, oats, and rye. Well, there's spelt. So that looks like, I don't know what dinkle is. Oh, you can make oil. Wow. All right. That's something new for me. Definitely going to try that out. Now, beef. Huh. Now, I'm confused about that because I don't see an option to buy beef cattle. Okay, so it does take sunflowers. I do not see soy. So, oat, rye, spelt, triticale, or triticale, sunflowers, oil, beef, and silage as well as the standards. So another one little thing we can do is let me just buy something. Let me buy a man truck, and I'll show you where it is. So there's where it is, up in the top right corner near Transport Pharma. That's the dealership. And let's reset it, and we'll see where it resets to. And it resets down to here. Back to your main farm. Cool. There are some odd set points in some maps. That's why I wanted to check that. That's one thing I didn't do off cam. Awesome. All right. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope I was some kind of help to you. I know it wasn't the most organized tour, but there's kind of a bit of guesswork involved with it all. So, please let me know what you think, and feel free to comment down in the comment section, say hi, anything you want, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again. So I hope you're having a great morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are in the world. So until we meet again, take good care of yourself, and bye-bye for now.